Hi everybody, and welcome to On the Couch with Nici, a new segment I've created where I bring to you topics that I think we should be discussing. So who's on the couch today? Well, recently I posted on the page a thread about cervical cancer and the HPV virus. This was a very topical thread. So many of you commented, asked questions, and I thought, I really want to dispel all the myths about this and clear up some of the questions that you had. So I am very excited today to have Dr. Joe, a gynecologic oncologist, here today to answer some of these questions. Thank you so much for coming in.
Glad to be here.
Today. It's wonderful to have you to answer all these questions. It's my understanding that 99% of cervical cancer is caused by the HPV virus, which we can screen for. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I grew up with the pap smear, which I'm sure a lot of
people... So did I.
From a different angle. And the pap smear also has to be done every year, whereas the HPV screening is done if you get a good result, that you're clear of HPV, you don't have to come back for 5 years?
Yes, that's right.
Okay, so that's a huge difference. Mm-hmm. I just want to explain that this test is done in the same way as a pap smear.
That's right.
Okay. There are over 100 strains of this HPV virus, but only 2 strains are the ones that we're concerned about, strain number 16 and 18. Most people will get this virus.
That's right.
Most people will get this virus. It's
incredibly common.
Incredibly common.
That's why it's called the human papillomavirus.
Okay, HPV so test. Like a common cold.
Absolutely.
Most people are going to get this virus, and most people are going to clear it themselves.
That's right.
Right, so we don't want to have any undue
stress
or panic about having a positive detection of something that you're naturally going to clear.
That's correct.
So what age do people get tested?
The recommended age to start screening is usually after age 25 or 30. Most recommendations are for screening to begin only after age 30 with HPV.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it sexually transmitted? Is this something, if I'd never had sex,
right,
would I need to worry about this? Can I still get it in other ways?
That's a good question. It's a very common question. Sexual transmission is the most common mode of transmission, but not the only mode of transmission. Yeah, so if you've ever had sex, chances are you've probably been exposed or come in contact with HPV.
Okay, and protected sex?
Any kind of sex.
It doesn't matter, protected or unprotected.
That's right. To reassure everybody, I think we need to think about HPV in terms of the downsides. If you get HPV infected, you're not symptomatic, it really doesn't cause any kind of a disease.
There's no symptoms.
I wouldn't know.
Okay, so that's that's important to mention. There are no symptoms, so you may not even know that you have it, which is why you need to get the screening.
That's right.
Can I just clarify with this sexual partner thing? This is not about having numerous partners.
Nope.
You could have had sex with one person only and still get it. So this is not about promiscuity or not being safe. This is just a virus that's very easily contracted.
It's just about being human, ain't
it? Okay. So when I went to see my doctor and asked about the HPV test, she looked at me blankly, didn't know. It was sort of pap smear all the way. So it's really important for people to ask for this test.
Everybody needs to understand that the pap test is not a bad test. A pap test is like a payphone, and the HPV test is like a cell phone, okay? You can still get in touch with somebody using a payphone, still works, okay? But it's just that we have a better test, okay? So for those women who still want to have their pap test, they can still get it. But in order for the pap test to be as effective as the HPV test, it has to be done every year.
So some countries streets ahead, Australia, the Netherlands. Tell me a bit about what's happening in the world of HPV.
Countries like the Netherlands and Australia already have national screening programs that use the HPV test instead of the pap test. And that's because it's just more cost efficient from a national point of view to do a test every 3 to 5 years or every 5 years instead of having women do the Pap test every year.
Okay. Yeah. Some doctors are still advising to do both, and you're saying that is not necessary.
Because the added benefit of adding a Pap to an HPV test in terms of detection ability, you don't get very much more benefit by doing that.
Okay.
But you still add the cost of the Pap.
Okay. Some of the HPV strains are not detected with the HPV screening?
That's correct. So HPV screening doesn't test for 100 strains.
Okay.
Yeah. Most contemporary tests will only test for about 14 strains, which are the key strains that are involved in about 90% of cervical cancer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Some of the comments that came through on the last, well, I just want to cover off, is that less than 10% of cervical cancers are not HPV related. Mm-hmm. And 3% are caused by rare HPV strains not detected by the test.
Yeah. So where
so
that
statistic? It's not foolproof.
Well, no test is 100%. Okay. So I want to preface that by saying that, you know, the Pap test was only about 50%, 50 to 70%. So this is way better, but we're not at 100% yet.
Okay. Yeah.
Again, there are going to be some cancers that are not HPV related. Yeah. And so those are going to fall outside of where we're screening, but...
Okay. Well, there you have it. No woman should be dying of cervical cancer in a developed country. The Pap smear test is antiquated. All you need to do is ask your doctor for the HPV screening, specifically strains 16 and 18 that cause 70% of cervical cancer. I hope this has been of value to you today. Thank you for watching On the Couch with Nici. See you next time. Hi everyone, just an update for you. Of course, after all this, I went to my doctor to book in for my own HPV screen test. I was very mindful of the fact that it's not necessary to do the HPV and the Pap smear. Australia is one country that has already eradicated the Pap smear, so to my mind it wasn't necessary. However, my doctor here in Singapore was still very insistent that to cover off all bases, I needed to co-test with the Pap smear and the HPV. So I did both. Here's an example of what the results might look like if you get your results back. You can see that the test result shows a clear indication of strains 16 and 18, which are the important ones to get cleared, and then the remainder underneath. So I'm very lucky that my test was negative, so I don't need to go back now for another 5 years. So that's huge. I'm very pleased with that. So just so you understand how the process worked for me, if cost is an issue, then just do the HPV screen test. If you really want to cover off all bases and cost isn't an issue, then you can still co-test. But I do think that moving forward, the Pap smear is on the way out, but not quite yet, it seems. Thanks everyone, good health to you all.